In this video, I am going to discuss about a new objective weighing method called as method based on removal effects of criteria. So this is the references I am following for solving this objective weighing method. As usual, in every weighing method, we have certain steps to follow. Here, there are a couple of steps. Like the first step is the formulation of a decision matrix then normalization of the decision matrix based on the beneficial and non-beneficial attributes, and the third step is to calculate the overall performance of the alternatives. Here they are using logarithmic function which are used to measure the aggregate performance of various alternatives, and the same case in the step 4. Now the removal of each attribute with respect to the alternative's performance are going to be calculated here. Next step is calculation of removal effect. Here the removal effect is calculated based on the step 3 and step 4 values. And the final step is estimation of the final weights based on the removal effects. Let us start by solving this MEREC method by selecting a basic decision making matrix. So here I am using an industrial robot application where the problem here currently we are not selecting any robot, but we are going to estimate what are the weights for these 5 criteria. So basically an industrial robot consisting of basic things as load capacity, repeatability, maximum tip speed and the memory capacity and the manipulator reach it has. Among these attributes, if you can see, the repeatability is a non-beneficial attribute. So the amount of operations which we are going to be performed on the robot has to be as low as possible, and the remaining all should be the higher value, that is the beneficial attributes. And these are the 7 alternatives which we have. So among these 7 alternatives, for these attributes we are going to estimate the weights, and this is the reference I have followed here. So the first step is we have to formulate the decision matrix. So we have already formulated the decision matrix. So next thing is we have to estimate the normalization of the decision matrix. So here the normalization is going to be takes place in 2 cases. For one beneficial, this is the formulae, and for non-beneficial, this is the formulae. So for the beneficial attributes, if you consider, so minimum divided by minimum of that entire alternatives divided by the current value. What I will do is, first thing is I will calculate the maximum and minimum values in a separate cells like this, and I am going to drag to the all attributes. Similarly for minimum values also to the column wise and again to the attribute wise. So now for the formula here is for beneficial is minimum divided by xij. So here the minimum value is this one, F4 divided by the current xij value, and this will be common for the all things. So here this is a non-beneficial, I will calculate it later. And again the maximum tip speed, the maximum tip speed is again the same, F4 divided by that first alternative and drag it to the bottom. Now just if I drag it to the first cell, if I double click it, and I can able to adjust to the next cell and press enter and drag it. Similarly for next manipulator reach also. So just I am changing only the first column and drag it. For the non-beneficial attribute, there is a formula called as xij divided by max of xij. So the same formula I will use it here, xij divided by max. Press F4, enter, and drag it up to bottom. So this is the normalization matrix. So step 2 is completed. Next thing is we have to calculate the step 3. So step 3, if we try to observe here, here we have a logarithmic value for nxj, that is the normalized value, and it has to sum, and it has to divided by 1 divided by m is nothing but number of attributes which we have, and this one we have to place it. So what I will do is equal to ln of 1 plus of, so the current cell is 1 divided by m, that is 5, multiplied by, and here I have to follow the summation of each thing. So for summation of each thing, I will take a arc, and we have absolute value also. So I will take ABS of ln of the current alternative NX, this one, close the bracket, and this has to be continue plus. So what I will do is I will copy this formula, just change this L5 to next cell, similarly plus, okay, then close the bracket, enter, and drag it to the all 7 alternatives. So now we have calculated the overall performance of alternatives, that is the third step we have completed. So next we will go for calculation of performance of alternatives by removing each attribute. So for example, let's say LC is there, so LC attribute we will remove, and we will try to calculate the summation or the logarithmic formula which we applied. The formulas are quite same, but only thing is we have to remove the current one. So let's see how we will go through it. So what I will do is I will copy this one, because most of the thing is same up to here. So I'll go here and I have to take the first cell, then I will copy this one, so instead of J5 I have to select this one, the four, and this load capacity will be common for this entire column, so I am just dragging it up to bottom. Next I will try to copy this cell and I will paste it here, but I will try to edit the formula, because here we have to omit this repeatability, because this criteria we are going to remove. The major method is that cell, it has to remove the effects of its own criteria. So what I will do is I will place it to the first one. Then automatically, if you can double click it, you can see that cell has been removed, and I will drag it to the bottom. Similarly, do it for the remaining three attributes like this. Now we have completed this fourth step. Next we have to go for calculation of removal effects of the above. Based on the above two steps, we have to calculate this one. That is, it's very simple. Like, we have to do summation and absolute with respect to step 4 minus step 3 is equal to ABS of this Sij minus this one, and at last we will do the summation. And see, this one is common for all this Sij, for all these attributes. So what I will do is I will make a 4 here like this. I think if I change it to the next cell, automatically this cell will be freezed. So I will drag it to the last, then up to 7 alternatives, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So up to last cell, we have got the values. So the next thing is we have to sum all these alternatives and we have to get the single value. For each attribute we have to get a single value. So the fifth step is completed. Next, the sixth step is we have to estimate the final weights. For estimating of the final weights, we have to take the summation of this EJ, that is we will get EK. So we have to take the summation of all these things. What I will do is I will take summation of this entire things and I will mark that one as EK. So now the weight WJ is equal to EJ divided by summation of EK. So simply I will take divided by summation and I have to take F4 here so that the column will be freezed and drag it to the end. So now if you can see here, so these are the weights which we have estimated for by using this method based on removal effects of criteria. And here the maximum tip speed is having the high weight as 0.3, followed by repeatability, followed by load capacity and memory capacity. Almost we have very closer values, and at last we have manipulator reach. So these are the weight contribution. We can check these weights are also equal to 1. So this is the way how we have to calculate the MEREC method. Thank you.